Hello everyone, and today I'm here with a new lecture that is perimeter and area of plane figures. And today I'll be discussing area and perimeter of parallelogram. So first let's talk about the properties of a parallelogram, and then we will talk about how to calculate the area and perimeter of a parallelogram. So let's begin. So here's a parallelogram, and the property of a parallelogram is that there are two pair of parallel and equal sides. That means when I talk about these two sides, they are equal of length and they are both parallel. And when I talk about these two sides, they are also equal and parallel. So that means we have two pair of parallel sides, and it is bit tilted, so it is more like a rectangle, but a rectangle has 90 degree at the edges, and in parallelogram there is no 90 degree. So that is the basic difference between rectangle and parallelogram. Other than that, they possesses the same property that they have the parallel and equal opposite sides. So the area of parallelogram is base into height, but we need to remember this, that height should be perpendicular to the base. That means when we have been given the base and height, they should make 90 degree in between them. So this, to clarify this concept, I will be solving few questions in which you will be understanding that what do I mean by the base and height at 90 degrees. So first let's talk about one other question, and then we will discuss on the parallelogram diagram. So here's a question that we have been given the base and height of the parallelogram, and we are required with the area in the first part, and in the second part we have been given with the area and height, and we need to calculate the base, and in the third part we have the base and the area, but height is missing. So we need to apply the formula for the area of a parallelogram to find these missing three lengths. So first one is a very simple case. We have the base, we have the height, we have the formula. Area of parallelogram is equals to base into height, and the height is given, which is perpendicular to the base. So I have just plugged in the formula that area of parallelogram is base into height, and area is equals to 12 into 7, that is 84 centimeter square. In the second part, I have been given with the area, but base is missing. So I will substitute the values. Area of parallelogram is equals to base into height. Area is 42, base is missing, that is B, and height is 6. So it is multiplying here. On the other side of the equals to, it would be divided. So 42 divided by 6, that is 7 meters. After that, talking about the third part, we have been given with base and area, and height is missing. So we will again use this formula. We will plug in the value of area, we will plug in the base, and height is missing. So 7.8 is divided on the left hand side of the equals to, and then we have the answer as 5.5 meter, that is the height. And now we, after having all the values of A, B and C, we will just plug in the values in the boxes, and we will complete our table. That is 7 meter here, 84 centimeter squared here, and 5.5 meter millimeters, sorry. So this is all for the first question. In the second question, I have been given with a shape in which I need to identify that which length would be the base and which length would be the height in order to solve this parallelogram. So I have been given with this parallelogram, and as I can see that this is making 90 degrees with this dotted line and this BC lines. So this BC is the base, and this 90 degree line is 9 centimeter, which is the height of this parallelogram. As you can see this, that this 10 centimeter and this 6 centimeter is not making 90 degrees in between them. Therefore, 10 centimeter cannot be base or height. And there is no such line which is making 90 degree with this line AB. There is only a 90 degree line with BC, so we can consider this base and this as height. So we will use the formula, we will use this base 6 centimeter, we will use height as 9 centimeter, and we will calculate the area which like we have done in the previous case, that area is 6 into 9, this 6 into 9 is 54 centimeter square. After that, we need to calculate the parameter of the parallelogram. So in order to calculate the parameter, we need to add all the values, that all the side values. That means when I talk about this parallelogram ABCD, the outer borders, that is AB, BC, CD and DA, these all lines are needed to be added up to get the parallelogram parameter. To obtain the parameter of the parallelogram, we need to add up all these sides, these blue lengths. So this is 10 centimeter and this is also 10 centimeter. So when we will add them, we will get 20 centimeter, and this is 6 and this would be 6 as well, as this is the property of parallelogram, that they both are equal of length and they both are equal of length. So after adding them up, this is parameter of a parallelogram, sum of all sides. I have added all the sides and I have obtained 32 centimeter as my perimeter. After this, I have one more question. In this question, I have been given with the parallelogram in which there are two lines that are making 90 degrees. But my question is to obtain the length of PQ. This length is needed to be obtained. I know the formula for the area of a parallelogram, that is base into height, and I know that they should be perpendicular. So if I calculate the area of this PQRS parallelogram, when I take this PQ as the base, this can be used as height as it is at 90 degree. And when I take this line as base, this line can be used as height as it is making 90 degree as well. So I can use either this pair of lengths 11.2 and 10, or this 8 meter and this PQ to obtain the area of this parallelogram. And as we know that this is a single parallelogram, that means the area would be equal in both the cases. So what I can do is, in order to find this PQ, I will first find the area of the parallelogram with the values given to me. That means I have this PR 10 meters and this 11.2, that is the height. We will use the formula for the area of parallelogram. I will use this base as 10, this 11.2 as height, and I will calculate the area as 112 meter square. Now I know the area of this parallelogram, I know the height, this 8 meter, and this PQ, the baseline, is missing. So I can use the formula again, and as the area would remain the same, the height is now 8 and the base is missing. So I can plug in these values to obtain the value of PQ. That is, area of parallelogram is equals to base into height. Area of parallelogram is 112 is equals to PQ is my base and height is 8 meters. After solving this is 8 multiplied, there it would be divided, and we will obtain the reading of PQ as 14 meters. So this is how you obtain the area and parameter of a parallelogram. So for now, thank you everyone.